gentlemen. I usually don't do this. I politely turn down invitations to speak at book launches because you do one, you have to do them all. And when this only reached out and sent the manuscript, I opened it. I thought, the terrorist's daughter. Now, there's been a movie called My Daughter, the Terrorist. But all right, skipped a few pages. And then came upon this story's own introduction. I think it was on page 7 of the typescript. And then I immediately sat back because the opening sentence grabbed me. It was Thissuri writing about leaving Sri Lanka, coming back, leaving from the plane, if I remember. And I thought, this kid can write. The prose was good. There was something fresh and arresting, and one did not have to make the usual charitable concessions when you read works of fiction written by Sri Lankan writers writing in English, and you tell yourself, well, you know, it's not quite the use of the English language that one is accustomed to, but it's Sri Lanka. But you don't have to make that concession when you read this read. Even when you're conscious that this is a very young person writing. She uses the language the way in which it's meant to be used. And I read the book pretty much at one sitting. And there was a gap because my wife, Sandra, had taken the script and she had started reading it. So maybe a few hours that evening I missed out on it, but before I went to bed I finished the book. It's that good a read. It's that good a read. And, as you might imagine, I read stuff, I talk a lot, and I usually don't finish a manuscript pretty much at one sitting within a day. This one I did, though I didn't know this story at all. And I certainly didn't know until I walked in here this evening that her parents were students at the University of Colombo when I started teaching there in the mid 1980s. That made me feel a little old, but I really didn't know anything about this story except her achievements. Now, this book works as a book. It is also the first important creative work of and in post-war Sri Lanka. This is our first post-war book. And I wish the president were here and some of his senior officials, his brothers certainly, and I wish Thissuri could send them a book by mail, because if there is to be post-war reconciliation, this is the roadmap. Thissuri has written the roadmap. And it's a roadmap of the heart. I was working on something like this with the person I consider Sri Lanka's finest living mind, Godfrey Jayatilleka, the founder of Marga. We're working on a roadmap. But I must say, in all humility, that Thissuri, probably because she doesn't carry the baggage that we do, has got to the heart of the problem, and the heart of the problem resides in the heart. That's the message of this. This book is a love story, or this book is about more than one love story. It's a story of young love, But it's also the story of being in love with this country, not in a touristy sense, nor in the sort of primitive, parochial, patriotic sense, but being in love with an almost impossible country. And this is very clear from Tesori's own preface, but also from the thought processes of her main protagonist, the terrorist's daughter, who is most certainly the most outstanding character of this work of fiction, Talian, short for Talianadi. The book really gets going from the first page, when Talia is determined to write it. And it, the pace that the book sustains through to the end is one of the writer's achievements. When you really race through the last few pages, you race through it not because you're impatient and want to sort of finish it off and toss it aside, nor because it is leading to some violent climax, which is usually why a book, a novel races. You're heading towards the denouement, which is usually very dramatic. Now this is a dramatic denouement that the book races to, but it's a denouement of love, of redemption, of reconciliation, of the triumph of human emotions, of higher human emotions, over the baser passions of conflict and revenge. The book maintains a brisk pace while doing many things at the same time. Now that's not easy even for visual novels, because when you try to tackle many themes, one tends either to get lost in the labyrinth and the book becomes unwieldy, or you keep it simple so you can move like an arrow to the end. This really manages to do both. She takes you through the labyrinth, but she never loses the thread of Ariadne. And that thread is that of love, not in simple sense, but with all its complications. Ethnic prejudices, the memories of violence, the conflict within the relationship and the conflict within the country. Now, it's not easy to get into the skin of the daughter of a Tamil separatist, terrorist chieftain. But Thisuri has chosen to try to do that. And to make it more complex, and she's chosen to make it more complex, this is a young woman who, as a baby, is adopted by someone who was to become a Norwegian diplomat. And you have love stories crisscrossing love stories. You have the love story of Talia's adoptive father, Eric, with his girlfriend, who works, believe it or not, eventually for the Reagan administration. So, I mean, this is ambitious. This book is ambitious. The characters are ambitious, especially for a young